us how the people of Eri Kingdom were freed from the bondage of Amish, the storm lord. But the spirit in her refused to give up. She waited for a long period before she had the opportunity to strike back.
Don't forget that the big game always appears when the hunter has given up the hunt for the day. Don't give up, because the darkest hour is always before dawn.
So, you are calling me a prominent man in this community?
Yes.
Haven't you heard that a crown is not the cure for an headache?
Oloye, let me ask you a question. How are you sure you will find refuge where you're going to? Remember, it is even the calm and silent river that drowns a man.
I don't care. Let me go there.
You don't care?
Let me go.
Let's go.
We need to look for a solution before this gets worse. Oloye! Oloye!
Somebody help!
Wait, let's go to the village and look for help.
Oh, my eye, somebody help!
People down.
Retoro, you've noticed that you and your cohort have risen up for this calamity in this community. It baffles us. How manage? People are sickness free. People are prosperous. The kingdom is surprised. What is happening?
Yes, he is right. Adetoro, please share your wisdom with us. Tell us what we need to do, because it's like the heavens are shut against us.
My fellow people of Eri Kingdom, don't you think that the reason for all these problems is because you have forgotten your first love?
First love?
Yes! Because I could remember in the time of Princess Edward, things were going on smoothly. But ever since she left us, calamities upon calamities have been the order of the day. Have you forgotten that she told us that it is written in John 15 verse 17 that if ye abide in me and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what you will and it shall be done unto you. My elders, for it is said that if a wall does not have an opening, the lizard cannot creep in. The reason why the devil has crept into our lives and planted tears among our wheat is because we have forgotten the Lord God Almighty that gave us victory in the time of Princess Ewade. Brethren, let us take unto ourselves the whole armor of God, that we may be able to stand in the evil days. Therefore, having our loins girt about with truth, having on the breastplate of righteousness, and our feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking on the shield of faith, wherewith we shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked.
I think I agree with Adetoro, because when Princess Ewade was still with us, we were not slothful in business, but fervent in spirit and serving the Lord. But ever since she left us, we have relaxed our mind, thinking it is all over.
I can still remember what she always tells us, that we should be sober, be vigilant, because our adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, looking for whom he may devour.
That is it. That is it, my brethren and the good people of Eri Kingdom. Now that we have all realized our mistakes and have seen where we got it wrong, let us go on to God in prayers. Let's ask for His mercy. Let's pray that He will forgive our sins and deliver us from all our problems. Because He said in His word that if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I look down from heaven. I will forgive their sins and heal their land. Let us pray in the Holy Ghost, just like Princess Ewade taught us.
Casting crown, lifting hands, bowing hands, is all we've come to do. Casting crown, lifting hands.
I can see. I can see.
Glory be to God. I also felt something.
Really?
I felt the presence of God Almighty.
Wow.
Just as we used to during the time of Princess Ewade.
The Lord is good. That was the move of God, as it was prophesied in the book of Joel, chapter 2, verse 28. That it shall come to pass as a word, that I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions. It was because we were far from our Creator. That was why the enemy penetrated. For the Bible says, draw near unto me, and I will draw near unto you. Put on the old armor of God, that you will be able to stand in the days of adversity.
I am the avenger of the Lord. Who are you to set my captive free? Shall the prey be taken away from the mighty? Are the lofty captive delivered?
Yes, because thus saith the Lord, even the captives of the mighty shall be taken away, and the prey of the terrible shall be delivered.
Don't you know that they are paying for what their fathers and forefathers have done? For it is written, the iniquity of the father shall be visited upon the children, even to the third and fourth generations.
And for this reason, the Son of God is made manifest, that he might destroy the works of the devil. And it will no longer be said again, that the fathers have eaten sour grapes, and the children's teeth are set on edge.
But these ones have waxed cold, and forgotten the law of their God. For it is written, because you have forgotten the law of your God, I also will forget your children, and will change thy glory into shame, and will punish them their ways, and reward them their doing.
I want you to read that if these people will flee to the city of refuge, they shall find protection from the avenger of blood. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and are saved. For he who the Son of Man has set free is free indeed.
A fully grown up tree can never be bent into a walking stick. I am not as little as you think I am. For the camellia changes color to match with the earth, but the earth never changes color to match the camellia. It is certain that you want to test the depth of the river with your both feet. I will show you that the same teeth a dog uses to play with its puppies is the same teeth is used to bite a stranger.
Turning things around. Olowokporo is turning things around. Olowokporo is turning things around for my good.